Dear Anna, it seemed like this day was so far away, but so close at the same time. The same way you were so close, but it seemed like I had to wait a lifetime to find you.
I vow to encourage you and to serve you with honor and grace. I said I wasn't gonna cry.
So the day has finally come. After all the back and forth, all the issues and struggles are now behind us. Today we start a new chapter in the book of life God prepared just for us. This is where these winding roads have I'm excited led. That we committed ourselves to each other and that we're breaking generational curses within our family. I can't wait to travel around the world with you, experience different cultures, and learn about different lifestyles. I'm excited just to have you, and now all of you. You've been a best friend, a lifelong partner, and now a wife. I've seen you grow and change so much. It's been such a beautiful thing to witness. I remember our first kiss at your favorite pond. I remember the first script you told me about. All the little things that bring out your heart and project your thoughts into reality. I cherish them all. Who would have thought that first kiss would have turned into a lifetime of love? A match made in heaven. By the time I finish reading this letter, we'll only be minutes away from saying I do. No matter how the day turns out, this will be the best day of my life. A day I will never forget. And the day I will marry the most beautiful woman I've ever met. Both inside and out, you're wonderful. And Owodogi, I love you.
I always dreamed that someday I could be. I'm here now. I'm here now. I will rise up. I will not fall. I will stand up. I will not fall. I will stay strong. I'm never giving up faith. I will go on.
James, we finally made it to the finish line. At the end of this day, it will be just you and I. I still can't believe we had the same Spanish class in high school 7 years ago and didn't even realize it. Until one random Sunday, you decided to show up to Grace Nation. I had no clue that you would become my husband. Isn't God good? He shocks us with the unexpected. James, you are the greatest gift that God has given me. Thank you for choosing me and for loving me. This is the start to many more moments in this abundant filled life we will have together. I can't wait to marry you. I love you, James.
Proverbs 1:9 says that wisdom has built her house and she has hewn out seven pillars. Forsake foolishness and live and go in the way of understanding. Wisdom builds a house in order for love to dwell. And we love to say everything's based upon love. But really, it's based upon wisdom. And the reason I'm talking about wisdom is because we have two people standing before us who are incredibly wise. I promise you, you're seeing wisdom personified in Enno and in James. These are two wise individuals. And the house that they are about to build together is going to be built based upon the wisdom of God that God has imparted to them. And James and Enno believe, and not only believe, but they both know wisdom, and wisdom has a name, and that name of wisdom is Jesus Christ.
I'm going to be honest. As a little girl, I didn't think this day would ever come. Some girls dream of their weddings, but I could never really see anyone really choosing me. Within the past 2 years, I have learned so much more about God's ability to fulfill His promises. You see, James, you are God's promise to me.
I remember not knowing what it was to love, or even finding somebody capable of loving back. I remember searching for so long and failing to find the reflection of the woman that was in my heart. I remember thinking it wasn't a possibility and wandering into avenues that didn't match my identity.
I pray for a man who is kind, humble, adventurous, and most importantly, a spirit-filled man of God who can lead me and my family.
I remember I wanted a woman who could support me when times were tough. A woman who could make me laugh. A woman who could ease my spirit. A woman who understood my mind. A woman who is beautiful, gentle, yet outgoing. A woman willing to grow and stand with me by choice, because that's what it takes to love.
Today, I commit myself to my answered prayers. James, I promise to stand beside you and to support your vision for our life together.
I'm grateful that God led me to you. I'm grateful that you said yes in that parking lot when we decided to start dating. I'm grateful that I had this opportunity to share this life with you. I'm grateful that when it seemed like hope was lost, you still stuck around.
I vow to be a wife that will support you in prayer, and I vow to keep God the center of our marriage.
And most importantly, I'm grateful that I found a woman that reflects my heart. I vow to always be there for you. I vow to lead you, to love you, to grow with you, and to cherish you, and to protect you.
James, you are my forever. And no matter the circumstances, I choose to love you every day for the rest of eternity. I love you. Okay, that's it. Okay. Love me hard.
This will be the day.